Got yours reconnected. Hold on. We're getting there. We're getting there. We're looking live. Live.
You getting there now?
Oh, yeah. All right. We're rolling.
Good stuff. Here we are once again, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome once again to the show. Live with Mike and Jim is back for another series just for you guys every single Thursday. A little late today. Just when you thought we weren't going to be, because you guys were looking, and you're like, man, where's the show at today? They're usually on by now. They're going to miss this week. No, just a little later than usual. Some of these shows might even be a little bit later because some people got an interview at nighttime, which is part of the reasons we struggled getting guests every week. But next week, we got another big one coming at you. But this week, got a local philanthropist, raises a lot of money for a lot of good causes around here, and he's been doing it for a long time, too. He's consistent with it, and every single month, there's a new cause he's raising money for, and his avenue for raising funds for local charities is through Southland Championship Wrestling, a pro wrestling organization that's been around for 6 years now, bringing pro wrestling to the Kankakee area, always in Chabance, Illinois, or in Monee, Illinois. I was a huge wrestling fan growing up, so I caught on to these guys really quick. We're going to get those guys on the show later on to talk about the pro wrestling side of things. But part of the reason these shows run is to raise money for these local charities as well as the sponsors. So we're going to talk about the sponsors, but first, I want to talk about the local charities here. With Erik, Olsen, local philanthropist, and nobody spends much more time doing the footwork when it comes to raising money for local causes than this guy right here. Jim, take it away with your part of this, and we'll get into Erik into this.
Well, I want to take a moment here and thank you guys that are viewing. The people that are tuning in live make this show really great. So, you know, right now we don't have a camera hand with us. So put in the comments anything you want to know. We'll answer the comments. We'll reply. And then if you've missed any of the stream, we've made it really easy for you to view on YouTube.
Easy, on YouTube.
Yep, so on my video, it's tagged in there. If Mike doesn't have the link on it, we'll share it on the comments. Go to the YouTube channel. If you click the subscribe button, we get notified. We'll give you a shout out. We appreciate it. And then also, it's a great way for you to see all the other, there's over 40 other videos and interviews of us exposing great things in this county. And what we're going to expose today is Erik Olsen and, how do you say, the philanthropist. I still can't say the word. But the philanthropist.
Sounds fancy.
It is fancy.
He just does what comes natural to him, and that's how he ended up where he is right now with this title of philanthropist. So let's talk about this. Erik, how did you get started raising money for local causes? Let's talk about the seed that was planted and how you transitioned into that part of your life.
Wow. Well, eventually the organization started out as CSW.
Okay.
We just rebranded last year, kind of our own entity now, but the first thing we planned was in partnership with JoJo Sason's organization for a kid, local kid that has spinal bifida, Mikey Gunny. We had a big, huge show, some celebrities from JoJo's foundation were here. And it was a big event. And so that kind of planted the seed for future things.
And Erik's a pro wrestler himself, as you've been pro wrestling since way back in the day. A lot of you guys might recognize him as the Keeper, check him out.
Keeper.
Recognize the space, how can you forget the space right here?
Yeah.
But he was a pro wrestler way back in the day, he took a bunch of years off. But when Hunter Payne moved to the area and brought pro wrestling back to the area, it was just a natural fit for Erik to hook up with Hunter Payne and get involved in pro wrestling. And your job has been, you weren't given the job, it just kind of came. You were the one that went out and got these local charities. So just in case you didn't get that part, that he's involved with Southland Championship Wrestling because he's a pro wrestler himself, but he's the one that does the footwork to get the local charities involved. So you started off with JoJo's local one first, Michelangelo Project.
Yes.
Okay.
Also, another partner that helped us start was John Thompson, the Lunatic. The initial three of us started us up and going. Well, after the Michael Gunny thing that we did, it was just a huge outpouring of support from the area of businesses and just people showing up.
Was that JoJo's idea, or was that?
I think it was something already in the process, and I believe JoJo ended up picking Mikey because Mikey made the paper. He was having one of his many operations, and he was playing video games.
Okay.
To help pass the time in hospital, and I think that just snowballed in. That first one being about Mikey.
Did he contact you guys about special? Did he want a specialty event, or is that pretty much?
I think it was it was a natural fit. JoJo does a lot of good things for the area.
Yeah, everybody knows JoJo.
Nationwide and worldwide also.
Yeah, if you guys know JoJo, tag him on this video. None of us have it on there, but he should be mentioned and recognized for all his hard efforts. Put him on there.
So then the local kids with cancer started hitting really close to home from the area. I grew up in the Limestone Hershey area. The first kid, Salem Bitstoffer, I went to school with her parents, and she had multiple battles. At one of our next, one of the shows after, I'm like, I had this old ECW championship belt just laying in my closet, you know.
Okay.
Just collecting dust. I was like, what can I do? So I was like, I want to raffle off this belt at one of our shows, and whatever money we raised was going to be donated to her parents for traveling expenses, gas, food, because they were going up to the hospital multiple times per week just to get her treatments and stuff, and that kind of starts snowballing.
And that was the first time you did something like that after JoJo's Michael project?
Yes.
Okay, so you just had the idea of helping the family out.
Yep.
Okay, good. That's what I wanted to hear right there. And then just kind of snowballed, and hey, this isn't such a bad thing. Why not just raise money for local charities at every single show?
Yeah, just keep
going. I mean, because you haven't missed a show since, right?
As far as I know, no. There might have been one or two over the past 4 or 5 years where we didn't plan anything just to make it a little more easier to put the show together, not have to worry about bringing representatives in from an organization, scheduling and this and that. And kind of like put the brakes on a little bit, let us just relax for one show, just put on a great show for the fans and stuff. And then there's not a lot of money being made in this doing this.
No.
We make enough money to pay everybody to pay insurance, ring rental, this and that. And if there's any money made, it goes back to the next show.
Yeah, most of these wrestlers get paid like $20 just to drive 4 hours to wrestle in front of 200 people. So they're not doing it. They're doing it for the love of the game.
Yes.
Right? Doing it for the fans, and they're doing it for a show. A lot of them, you know, their families either stay at home or they come with them. But these wrestlers travel every single weekend. And Southland Championship Wrestling just happens to attract some of the best independent pro wrestlers in the entire Midwest. And that's why they're willing to drive 2, 3, 4 hours just to wrestle in Japan, to wrestle for such a great organization. And they've been around 6 years now, and it started off with just a few shows a year.
Yes.
Now we're up to how many shows a year now?
About 10 a year. We take January, February. We were taking off, but we started running shows in February at the Second Place Church in Monee. So we take June off because of graduations and stuff. It's a busy time of year. Then we start back up in July and run all the way through December. So
10 shows a year, and every single show they're raising some funds for a good cause. And it's always somebody different, too. So let's talk about some of these local charities we've helped out, and they might resonate with some of them.
I got a list. I got lots of names here. Just recently, we did our last show was for Casey Costa, the sexual assault program here in the area, Harbor House, St. Jude's, the Salvage Yard Biker Church, Special Olympics, the Veterans Assistance Program here in the area, MS. It just, the list goes on and on and on.
This pro wrestling show raises funds for all of these good causes every single month. That's part of what they do, Southland Championship Wrestling. Check them out on Facebook. Who else you got?
Just so many. Again, the Second Place Church, we help out their mobile food pantry up there in Monee. Operation Bunny Drop was an Easter toy drive.
Yeah, and they could just put on a pro wrestling show and leave it at that. But no, they're giving some of the proceeds to these local charities as well.
It's never ending. If there were 24 months in a year, we would fill those 24 months with an organization to raise money for. Unfortunately, that's just the case. You know, there's so many cancers, MS, muscular dystrophy, Duchenne's muscular dystrophy is just primarily in young boys. Ethan's Army was another one that we did a while back for Duchenne's muscular dystrophy. The list, Ashley Camp Foundation, we were trying to find bone marrow matches.
We all took swabs instead of getting
swabs.
We were matched.
And I think we collected over 30 pamphlets that were sent in, and unfortunately, you know, the way things happened, we weren't able to find a match, and she was one of the other ones that had passed from multiple bouts of cancer. I mean,
we gave it a shot.
Yes.
We got 30 people to send in swabs.
The list continues on. Austin Scott, he was another boy that we followed, and he passed. He's got a foundation starting up, which is the first event is on the same night as our next show, which is unfortunate. It's called Austin's Humble and Kind Foundation.
Yeah, that kid was always in the front row yelling smack at all the wrestlers. And I was his least favorite one. He was always yelling at me. And he got in my face a lot. So I remember that kid. And
he was a redheaded kid, and he had fire. And you know what?
He was full of fire.
God bless him. And, Austin Barnett, he was the first boy I fought to start following with cancer, multiple bouts again. The same school district, the same area, Limestone Hersher area.
What makes you choose these particular?
It's just the young kids, you know.
Yeah.
I guess I'm still a young kid at heart.
If you're a pro wrestler, yes, you are a young kid at heart.
Yeah. You're living a dream like you're a superhero or something.
Yeah.
I wasn't able to make it big in football or baseball, but this was just, like Mike said, he watched it since he was a kid. I gravitated towards it, and you're out there as some type of idol, some type of someone for somebody to look up to, and you brighten some kid's face just for a minute out of their bad day because they're going through chemo, they're walking on crutches, they're confined to a wheelchair. And even kids with special needs, like the River Valley Special Rec Center, Good Shepherd Manor out moments, these special needs people and participants, they come to our shows and it's the time of their life, just to see how they react and have fun and just get out of their everyday routine.
Eric's actually been to the hospitals visiting these kids, in character, because they're local pro wrestlers, but these kids look up to these guys. So Eric does his role and he goes around the hospitals, visits kids. He spends all kinds of time with all kinds of people when he does these kinds of events. Take it away, Jim.
Yeah, I've been blessed to be a part of a lot of the SCW events. I say a lot of, a very small amount, I guess.
He's the limo driver. That's a big deal.
But yeah, we donate our time in the limo and some things to be able to help them make it a great event. But it's not about that. It's just, to be able to see someone like Erik here genuinely take his time and care about a cause, and to be able to do it through an avenue that's he passionate about, And so thank you for that, too, because I think it's awesome that someone gets to be able to do that and have fun and be a kid themselves.
Oh, it's definitely like being a kid when you're running around in tights or in whatever, just being in your character is more like a part of yourself already, and that's the easiest way to go about it. We have a great group of guys that come down here. Like Mike said, they travel hours sometimes just to be a part of our organization, to do things like this. Marche Rocket, Mikey Gunny, the kid with spinal bifida, they like gravitated toward each other like nothing. And Mikey got to accompany Marche to the ring a couple of times, which is cool. To have these kids come out with you and be a part of the show. Some kids get a little scared and a little nervous at first, but it's like coming through that curtain and everybody backstage knows you're waiting, your music hits. And if you don't get, this is like something like the Rockwood says, you feel your music kick, you're getting ready to walk out.
Yeah.
To us, it's just hundreds, but to him, it's millions, You get goosebumps and stuff. If you don't get goosebumps coming out to your music and just seeing and hearing the crowd, then, you don't get it. It's like the first time, every time you go out, it's to have kids accompany you to the ring. Either if you're a bad guy or a good guy, kids will gravitate towards you if they like you.
Well, let's talk about that.
Let's talk all about that.
Yeah, before we shift gears here, more of these kids in a little different ways. If you just joined the live stream, we got a few more people that just jumped on. Thanks for joining. We're here with Erik Olsen talking about how the different ways he's raised for a bunch of different charities through SCW, and raising funds isn't easy.
No, it's not.
So take a minute, share this video, share the stream, especially if you didn't hear the list he just went through for all the things he's helping out with. Check it out on our YouTube channel when this is posted, but help us share this word, share and just get awareness, because that's the best way, I believe, to help with fundraising is create more awareness.
Yeah, share it, get the word out.
And that's one of my questions for you before we move on to this bully subject.
Sure.
Is, for anybody watching this video right now, what's the easiest way they can help with your cause? Even if they don't want to donate money to it, they don't want to put in their time, what's something they can do to help out?
It's Facebook and the smartphones make it so easy nowadays for spreading the word and getting the word out for anything in business, life, just keeping in contact with people. There's always something going on that I'm posting on Southland. I'm posting on my personal page or my other pages. I have a couple other pages that I post stuff. And the more people it reaches, the better. And we have every event the people that come in, like from Casey Casa, the three reps that came in, and they're like, we've never seen anything like this before. We're coming back again because it's a great stress relief.
Yeah. When you get to yell at wrestlers, yes,
it's a stress relief for the hard work they do with sexual assault victims. It's a stress relief. It's a stress relief for families that have kids that are fighting ailments. To get them out and to see them have fun is a stress relief for the parents. So, and it's in it, you know, it could be young adults, it could be, I mean, adults like the Special Rally Rec Center. They're not all kids, and they just eat it up.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's something they get to look forward to, and we're even recognized in their monthly scheduling pamphlet that they send out. We're in there as SCW, the next events when they're coming up, times and stuff. So,
yeah.
So you guys here, share this.
Share it.
Follow the SCW page.
Follow SCW page.
And have some fun with it. Have some fun with it.
Have all kinds of fun with it.
I know you might have some more questions, and we'll talk this out on live. Since we're not doing a tour today.
No tour.
Do we want to get a couple words of wisdom for anybody out there looking to raise funds for an organization?
Well, we do that. Let's do that too. Words of wisdom. Because this guy also does all the, this guy organizes all the events that South Plains Championship Wrestling works with, and he also organizes all the sponsors. This guy's just like, he's like the organizer behind the scenes.
Yeah.
When Hunter Payne is working all day long, Eric's making sure the show behind the scenes is working.
Yeah.
He's very organized when it comes to that kind of thing. So this is the keeper, Erik Edwards. Out of character, Erik Olsen today. This is who he is. This is what he does. He doesn't get paid to do it. All this just comes natural to him. Actions speak louder than words, and Eric's actions is exactly who he is and what he wants to do, and he's showing you that. Because on May 19th,
May 18th,
we got a show. So let's talk about the bullying and what we're doing this time around.
The bullying thing is, it's an epidemic, worldwide.
Yeah.
And it's out of hand. We were all kids at one time.
Yeah.
Yeah, we might have been bullied, or we might have done a little bit of the bullying too. But the epidemic, I think, has just gotten out of hand because it's the social media aspect of it. I think that's heightened a lot of it.
Yeah,
it's easier to get stuff out there, even if it's something negative like bullying.
Yeah, it's like the fundraiser of the yin and the yang. You get a lot more awareness.
Well, bullying's a big deal. So what if a kid's watching right now, or a parent whose kid is getting bullied at school is watching right now? If a kid's getting bullied at school, which happens like in kindergarten nowadays, what can a kid do and what should a kid do if he's getting bullied at school?
That's a tough question because multiple stories, even in our area, stuff has been brought up to schools, the principals, the teachers. And from what I've read and understood and gathered, I don't think there's enough being done in our school districts or in the area in general as far as the bullying epidemic. Just a couple months ago, a father got arrested for getting on a bus, making threats towards kids that were bullying his daughter. And apparently the school district wasn't doing anything about it, not doing enough about it. And every parent's going to have a snapping point.
Yeah, definitely.
And unfortunately, the father, he got arrested and got in some trouble. I don't know anything else about the story, but that's just one story out of thousands.
Do you think the schools just aren't making it a big enough deal or a big enough issue to deal with? Or what is it exactly you think needs to happen that isn't happening?
That's a hard thing.
Well, we ask tough questions tough questions.
Right. Amongst the three of us and everybody here in this area, we know a lot of people that work in the schools. The school district I went to, I know at least five or six people that are in the schools as far as teachers and high up as assistant principals. Family members that I know work at some of the local schools. And as far as teachers, I think it has to go further up. It's got to go through the school board, it's got to go through the state to get more stuff implicated into our schools as far as anti-bullying.
So we know how the state works, we know how the school works, and God bless everybody in those
buildings. God bless everybody.
But they're slow, right?
Teachers,
and there's not enough out there.
Teachers are under...
Yes, they are.
Underappreciated.
Pay everything.
So what do we have, when I say we, what do you guys have going on that we want them to know about that's helping with this?
Yeah.
This is a brand new thing. We were searching for a local anti-bullying foundation or charity, and we were kind of striking out Kalen Patterson from here. He pointed me in the direction of a place in St. Louis, an awesome organization and Unfortunately, he can't make it to the show because of scheduling.
Yeah.
He's a full-time cop.
It's a four-hour drive.
He's a full-time cop. He's getting a master's degree at night, and he's just so busy he can't make our main show. So me and Jeff, my partner, like, where can, you know, local-wise, Genesis Martial Arts and Fitness, Doug Keast, he put himself out there on the lines, like, hey, I will put together a program for kids. Anti-bullying / seminars, not necessarily about self-defense, you know, that's a whole different avenue. It's about avenues that the kids can take. If something not being done, that they think, you know, they need to go to your parents, go to your school, your teachers, your principal, and just, it's easier said than done.
Yeah,
it's definitely easier said than done, because it sounds like that's being done, but not enough to be not being done about it.
Yeah, a lot of kids wouldn't want to go to their teachers. They don't want to be a tailor or whatever. Yeah, I understand true. That, too. That's why it's so tough, because that's what kids are supposed to do, but then there might be repercussions if they end up doing that, because then they're known as a tattletale, and it might even make some more kids mad. Who knows? So that's not always the end. It's like, so what are you supposed to do exactly? That's what part of this is about, to increase awareness and to get information out to the kids. We've talked to Bernie Gorab, we've talked to Doug Keast on their thoughts on bullying. And, you know, they say things like, keep your chest up high. If you're not confident, just look like you're confident. Make eye contact. Keep your head up. Don't walk with your head down, otherwise you're an easy target. You can always take a different way, take a different hallway, something like that. There's a few things you can do. And my answer is always go to Genesis and learn how to throw a right hook, because it's better to know it and not need it than to need it and not know it. Right? At least if you know it, if you have to use it, it's there. Not all people agree with me, but my answer is go to Genesis, get your kids in boxing classes, because I got boxing there, and at least teach your kids how to defend themselves if they're ever in that position. Hopefully they don't get to that point, you know, but that's an answer as well.
Yeah, the foundation, what I realize is it's not really the defense in itself physically as much as it is mentally preparing yourself, the coping with it, how you react to these situations. So,
see, that's why we're live with Mike and Jim, because I think one way Jim thinks another, so we compliment each other well. You know, I come up telling you to teach your kids how to fight, and Jim calms them down a little bit.
It's a good balance.
And that's a big part of it as well.
And we want to say thanks for staying. If you're staying here till the end, we appreciate you being a loyal Live with Mike and Jim viewer, hearing about what we got going on. Obviously, this is a bit different than our typical
business.
It is
a bit different.
But it's funny to hear how Erik came about. You know, he came in wanting to do this. There was an organization here where he was able to flourish. And then to wrap up with the bully conversation is, you know, there wasn't something here in town to solve the problem, and you guys went out and created it. Just like how most small businesses organizations are built.
And hopefully it takes off, because, you know, just getting kids involved with something, it's not necessarily going in there and learning how to defend yourself, which you probably would learn a little bit. But it's the coping skills and being around other people that have the same issue as you kind of helps. Like, so many of these kids that I've followed with cancer and ailments, their families I've met have become friends. And, you know, just, you know, if they wouldn't have met at our shows, they might not have ever met.
Right.
You know, also Scott made a strong bond with Andrew Ewers, which he's a special needs kid with cancer. So he's got like a double, he's got two strikes against him. And, you know, they bonded, their parents bonded, and, you know, Austin, all these kids with any kind of disease, they always look out for somebody else instead of themselves.
Yeah, definitely.
That's what I've noticed being around them. I wish I was around kids more often like this than I can. I wish I could do this full time and make a living at it, because I would. And my wife said to herself that we would be rich if you were making a living and doing this. Like, it's not about making money. It's about helping out, just brightening somebody's day.
Heck yeah.
You know, pay it forward. You know, there was a pay it forward day last week, I think. And I'm thinking, I'm paying forward every day all year round. So
yeah.
I don't have to celebrate that day, you know. But it's hard to put it into words on how I feel about it.
Yeah.
Well, we appreciate you brightening our day.
Right in our day.
Heck yeah.
The sun's always shining.
And help pay it forward, too. If you got a minute, hit the share button. It's super simple. Get this word out. Awareness for all of what we're talking about on this show is the best way to help out.
Yeah.
No tour today. Right?
Anything else? We're at Pit by the U right now. We're in the conditioning room at Pit by the U right now. So No tour today. If you guys want a tour, you can just stop by and go on that Larry Hall Road. One more thing I wanted to talk about. Let's talk about the sponsors, because Erik does all the good work for the raising of the funds for local charities and sponsors. Listen to some of these sponsors that sponsor South Bay Championship Wrestling.
Well, initially, you know, short story here. Initially, there were three of us, and it's so hectic. We're working full-time jobs, running around.
It's tough stuff. And get people to want to donate to pro wrestling.
And mostly it's through Facebook Messenger and stuff that I've gotten good at, just reaching out. And it's word of mouth also, you know, word of mouth. You know, Eric's looking for somebody, you know, family's business or something, and it's still spreading.
Yeah.
I mean, over the past almost 6 years in September, I can't even count how many sponsors we've had. But for this show, Card Connection, Niles Crum, he's our main sponsor for this.
Niles is the man.
Yep, Card Connection. Glassworks, they're a sponsor every month. Pace Setters. Midwest Integrated Solutions is coming back. Steve Wilder. Limitless Supplements, local entrepreneur Brandon Reynolds, he's always sponsoring us. And, you know, the list goes on. I was sitting at home right now, going through my phone and all the old flyers that we've had. You know, Bob's Auto, The Pampered Look, The Netbox, World Ventures, Happy's Pizza, Fit Body U.
Who's sponsored?
Tanner's Auto Body, Reliable Auto Care, Genesis Martial Arts and Fitness, Calmese Wellness. Another fitness. You know, here's the thing about local fitness places. They're not in competition with each other.
Most of them are.
You got a few, but, you know, I went to Mike and said, hey, would you mind if I got Calmese to be a sponsor? No.
Everyone's got their own niche. Yeah.
Dragon's Refuge down here, another gaming place, the Looney Bin and Bulls Barbecue.
Looney Bin.
Nick Hoffman, story about Nick Hoffman.
Brought Jake the Snake to the area.
Yeah. And the Bushwhacker and the Honky Tonk Man.
What's the story about Nick
Hoffman? Nick helped me out with a couple of these kids with cancer, with all his contacts through entertainment and stuff. Austin Barnett was a huge fan of that show, Ridiculousness. Rob Dietrich, I believe is his name. Nick was able to set up a FaceTime video with Austin Barnett and Rob, that was a thing. That would have never happened if it wasn't for somebody.
Wow.
He was trying to put in contact Dog the Bounty Hunter with Austin Scott. Austin Scott, he had a Make-A-Wish granted to him, but unfortunately, he wasn't able to make it. But we were Nick was trying to reach out to Dog because his wish was to go to Hawaii.
Wow.
And that's where Dog hangs out. His business is Bail Bonds thing. It got, you know, kind of shut down pretty quick because wasn't able to make it happen. But hands off to Nick. You know, Nick.
He's a plan.
Nick is his own guy, but I think he's got a big part underneath that rough front exterior.
Oh, yeah. He's done more good than most.
Yes, the Huddle's been another sponsor. Serenity Massage, the bar in Clifton.
The bar in Clifton.
The bar. Bradley Brown Chevy before it was Phillips. Wayne Lincoln was a contact there. Extreme Maintenance, Bob's Barbershop in Hersher. Sammy's Pizza has been,
of course,
a location for an after show party a couple of times and just a regular sponsor.
Can't go wrong with Sammy's Pizza.
Sammy's Pizza. Burgers and Beer.
Oh, best burgers in the world.
Heatwave Heating and Cooling.
The Foul Player.
Precision Piping's been a sponsor a couple of times. Dawn Olsen Realtor, she's been a sponsor a couple of times.
Can't forget Dawn.
Anthony Auto Parts, he's been a sponsor multiple times. JoJo, he was a sponsor. SIS Home Inspections, that's Scott Seaton's Home Inspection business for real estate. And Pearl Dodge.
Okay, now let's talk about this. These are all the sponsors, most of the sponsors that have sponsored Southland Championship Wrestling over the last 6 years. And Erik's done most of the footwork of getting these spots. Not all of it, but most of it. And there's a lot of people out there looking for sponsors that just aren't getting the job done. So what advice would you have for somebody who's looking? Like, I get a lot of competitors, bodybuilders, fitness models, always asking me, how can I get a sponsor? And my advice is always, well, they need somebody that's going to actually get the word out for them. You can't just look good and raise your hand and say, I want a sponsor, and expect to get anything in return. Right. What are you going to do for them? How are you going to get the word out? Are you a peak person? Do you put enough out there on social media that's going to make it worth it for them to want you on the board as a sponsor? You got to get the word out for people if you want a sponsor. Erik's got all these sponsors, obviously he's doing something right. So what's your advice for somebody out there looking for sponsors themselves as to how, because you got shot down a lot too. You got a lot of doors slammed in your face. These are just people looking for up for. So this doesn't count the number. I bet you five times as many people slam doors in his face. So let's talk about the advice you have for somebody out there looking for a sponsor. And what to do when you get a door slammed in your face.
I don't think I've had the door slammed per se physically, but usually, you know, here's the thing. Putting it out on Messenger and giving them examples of flyers, what they look like and stuff, and they're bang for their buck. You know, 1,500 flyers is usually what we put out in the area with your logo on it, your business. Either if you're a main sponsor, you're on the front, or just a sponsor, you're on the back. Main sponsor gets on the tickets, which is roughly 350 tickets we get printed every show. It's, as far as I know, it's pretty cheap advertising. And plus the Facebook, the boost posts.
Yeah, that makes it easy.
Everybody's sharing, getting tagged, sharing their business. The wrestlers, you know, we have up to maybe, I say, between the workers and wrestlers and family members and stuff that are involved with us, at least 100 people are posted and tagging.
Yeah.
And then when you start to, you know, it just snowballs. You start tagging, and it just builds and builds and builds and builds. And we're still getting new people coming to our shows.
Yeah.
That have never seen it before. And it's going on 6 years or something.
Yeah. Because we're so consistent with these shows every single month that the fans are getting to learn all about the wrestlers and they want to keep seeing more.
Word of mouth. We used to go out physically, the businesses, with a plan on sponsorships and stuff. And believe it or not, that was harder, per se, because you get somebody like me or John the Lunatic or Jeff Hunter Payton. Jeff's 6'7" or whatever, 300-something pounds. He looks like he's mad all the time. And he always messages in types and capitals, so even if he's just texting me, it sounds like
he's mad.
But you walk into a business cold, like cold calling.
And they don't know you.
They don't know you. Yeah. You got these guys coming in.
And you're asking for money the first time you ever met someone before.
So it's kind of rough. So the Facebook and the Messenger and stuff, it's a little bit easier. It gives something then for them to visually look at and see while they're not trying to take care of their business, not trying to take care of customers. And yeah, I do get, you know, I put out a lot of messages and I get a lot of, you can tell when somebody sees it and whatever.
Because it says seen, respond back. If he sends you a message asking for a sponsorship, at least respond back with something and say, this is not a good time for me.
Right.
Don't just blow
it. And that's usually the case. You know, people say, not this time, think of us in the future and stuff.
Right.
You know what I mean? And,
okay.
And for the most part, it's just cut and dry. You do and you don't. And, and I don't like sending multiple messages to people every month.
I try to
cycle it, you know, we usually get a good 4 to 5 that are almost every month.
Yeah.
That are on top of things every month with us. And we try to look for about 2 or 3 more maybe. Because, it helps with the sponsors really help us out a lot. I mean, as far as advertising for them, it helps us keep the ball rolling, keep these shows going.
Helps pay the wrestlers, helps pay the band.
That we can do with these work and get the word out for these different charities.
And so we can keep raising money for these local charities. So the sponsors help us continue to be able to raise funds for local charities. And this coming May 18th show, the main sponsor is Card Connect. So Niles Crum, thanks for sponsoring us once again. Jim, go ahead. Say one more thing.
Yeah,
Niles, your show.
Niles was contact with Mike. We, a group of us, helped him move it. Niles moved a big, heavy, old school treadmill out of his basement. We had to take it apart because it was so heavy. There's five of us. Moved it to a new house. Ended up not working out at that house, and then ended up got moved back. Thank God somebody else moved it. But Niles was such a kind and generous soul. He paid us, didn't want us to leave without getting paid.
But he insisted that we took the money.
He insisted it. So he was trying to strong arm us. Well, okay, we'll take the money.
He did. I didn't want to tell him no.
So, Mike, I've contacted him quite a bit, and I've met him a couple times. I went to his office, gave me the tour of his office over there on 45.
Yeah, he's classy, man.
The old David Journal building.
Classy.
45, and he's a...
class act.
Class act.
What he is.
He wants to take all of us out to steak dinner one time. You don't have to do that, you know.
I'll let him take it to a steak dinner.
Oh, I know you will. But yeah, what do you got, Jim?
Well, that's how I met Niles, too. He called me up out of the blue. He assumed, well, since this guy owns a gym, I need some guys to help move my treadmill. I'll call this guy who owns a gym, and he's probably got a few strong guys to help me out. I never met Niles before, and I never even answered my phone either. He just happened to call me, and I happened to answer my phone, which is rare. It was Niles. He told me his situation, that he was moving and needed a few guys to help move a treadmill, so we can help him move this treadmill. And now he's the main sponsor of Southland Championship. Sorry, Jim.
Hey, nah, no apologies for me, man. I'm here to wrap it up.
This is how things happen.
That's good stuff to get out.
It's a nice place to meet people. You know, you never know. You got to get out and about. You got to expose yourself to get yourself into those types of situations to give yourself the opportunity to make it happen.
Yeah, and it's like you can never imagine the outcome.
No.
Of such a simple gesture. Yeah.
No, simple gesture. I got to get better at simple gestures myself. I'm getting better at simple gestures.
Well, this show today was all about more than a simple gesture.
Local
philanthropist right here, Erik Olsen. We appreciate you, the viewer, being on this show. If you stay to the end, do me a favor, share the stream, get awareness out. That's helping this guy out a big whole way, and then it's helping out way more than what you would ever think by helping him out.
Yeah.
That's all I got for him. Well, follow the YouTube.
Yeah, follow YouTube page. Yeah, just type Live with Mike and Jim in the search engine box on YouTube. We have about 40 videos up there now,
and
you'll have fun watching all those to keep you busy. If somebody's watching right now, Erik, and they want their local charity to be a part of South Plains Championship Wrestling, or if there's a sponsor out there, a small business owner, you want to sponsor from anywhere from $100 to $250 a show, if you want to sponsor, how do they get a hold of you?
Instant Messenger is the best way, Erik Olsen.
With a K.
With a K.
E-R-I-K.
That's the only way to spell Erik is
Olsen, not Olsen.
O-L-S-O-N.
Yeah.
You'll know it by Facebook. You'll be able to tell it's me. You can message us through the SCW page, Southland Championship Wrestling.
On Facebook.
On Facebook. Just help spread the word. You know, and if any other businesses are up for sponsorship, let me know. I'm always looking.
Yeah.
We have shows for the rest of the year.
Rest of the year.
Might not be this month or back in July when we start back up.
Yep.
All the way till December.
But if you want to see what South Lake Championship Wrestling is all about and the excitement that they bring to the area, May 18th, what's the show all about? What's it?
May 18th is at the Chaban Civic Center.
Chaban Civic Center.
The name of the show is called Retaliation. We kind of have a title for every show, kind of like how the big boys do it on TV. You know, they got a name for all their big shows.
Yeah.
And we're helping anti-bullying program at Genesis get up and running.
So if you buy a ticket, you'll help raise funds for the anti-bullying cause.
Yeah, we'll have a donation pot going around there.
Split the pot, concession stand.
Split the pot, concession stands. Last show was the first time ever we've ever ran out of concessions. We ran out after intermission, I believe, in the almost 4 years we've been in Chaban's. So that tells you, like, our fan base is growing and growing and growing and growing. So, I mean, that's a good thing to run out of stuff when you've never run out of it before.
Yeah.
So, I mean, it kind of stinks for the fans and stuff, but it lets us know, oh, shoot, we need more stuff.
Yeah, so we're tracking, 200 people in attendance each show. We're getting close to it anyway.
And that's
more than a lot of independent shows.
And it's a good crowd at the Chaban Civic Center.
They get into it, too.
Now, and, you know, the kids are going to get a little bit more rowdier than usual sometimes.
Yeah, because they know the wrestlers aren't going to fight back. So these kids, they know they can yell whatever they want at the bad guys, and they know the bad guys aren't going to do anything back. So these kids aren't afraid to tell you exactly what they think.
And they will tell you what they think exactly. You know, it's fun. It's fun seeing their reactions. You know, the special needs kids, the participants and stuff, they get a rise out of it. And, you know, even the adults. You know, our fan base is probably a good mix of adults and young kids, and they love it.
Yeah. So if your kids love pro wrestling and they've never been to a live pro wrestling event before, right here in this area, Chaban's, Illinois, exit 302 off 57, live pro wrestling is taking place, and some of the best independent wrestlers in the whole entire Midwest are going to be the Marche Rocket, Ian Gager, Elite Payne, Marco Anthony, Lunatic, Nick Nessler, all of them. Lumberjack's going to be there. There's a lot of guys, a lot of good names in the Midwest going to be there, and on top of this, it's all to raise funds for a good cause. So come be a part of it all. May 18th, It's on a Friday night.
It's on
a Friday night. So doors open at 7. Match will start at 8.
Yep, right.
We'll try to get you done by 10:30 or so. Get your tickets at Fit Body U. Get your tickets at Genesis. Or get them at the door for $2 more. But either way, you make an appearance. If your kids like watching it on TV, imagine how much fun they would have at a live pro wrestling event. So do something different. Don't just stay home and watch movies or go out to eat. Do something different that they wouldn't expect. Live pro wrestling, May 18th, coming at you.
That's it. Come next week.
Awesome.
Live with
Learn
Mike and Jim.
About the Northfield Square Mall.
Oh, we got the Northfield Square Mall manager next week, Thursday. Be on the lookout.